बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन चैप्टर 2 क्लास 11 सीबीएसई एनसीईआरटी। दिस चैप्टर इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग बिकॉज इन दिस चैप्टर वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अबाउट हाउ लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स आर ग्रुप्ड इनटू डिफरेंट कैटेगरी। सो फार देयर हैव बीन नंबर ऑफ साइंटिस्ट हु हैव ट्राइड देयर बेस्ट टू क्लासिफाई लिविंग ऑर्गेनिजम्स। सो लेट अस हैव अ लुक इनटू बायोलॉजिकल क्लासिफिकेशन सिस्टम। Now it was necessary to classify living organism because living organisms were of great use. We were using living organisms for food, shelter and clothing. So in this directions, that means in order to classify living organisms, Aristotle was the first person to attempt a scientific basis for classification. Now who was Aristotle? Aristotle was the person who belonged to the time period of 384 to 322 BCE, that means ancient time period. Aristotle is considered as one of the great person. He was a Greek philosopher and he was also the teacher of Alexander the Great, who invaded our country. So Alexander the Great invaded our country but had to face a fierce battle with the King Porus. Anyways, Aristotle was the person who taught Alexander the Great. So let us see what type of classification was given by Aristotle in the ancient time period. So at that time period, Aristotle observed various kinds of living organisms. So what he noted at that point of time was that there were trees with woody stem. There were short plants without any woody stem. Then there was a third category of green plants which did not have any kind of woody stem. Rather, they were very soft in body. He also observed few animals which had white color blood and some who had red color blood. So based on all these morphological features, Aristotle had given the classification. So in Aristotle classification, we have plants and animals. Now plants were further subdivided on the basis of morphological characters. So on the basis of morphological characters, Aristotle divided plants into three categories. First, trees. Trees were those organisms which had woody stem and the main stem was with trunk. So this was the tree. Second, shrubs. Shrubs means plants which are woody but the main stem was totally absent. Third category as defined by Aristotle is herb. Herbs include plants with very soft body. Now apart from plants, Aristotle also classified animals. Now the basis of classification of animal was on the basis of blood color. So he noted down the blood color. Now what Aristotle observed was that there are two kinds of animals. First, without red blood and second, with red blood. So this was the classification given by Aristotle. Second attempt to classify living organism was done by Linnaeus. So Linnaeus had classified entire living organism into two kingdom, Plantae and Animalia. Now who was Linnaeus? Linnaeus was basically a Sweden biologist and he had done considerable work in the field of biology and the time span was 1707 to 1778. Now, do you remember any significant event happening at that time in India? Well, yes, Britishers, especially the East India Company, have already entered our country. And 1 year before Linnaeus gave this classification, that means in the year 1757, there was a major battle of Plassey in which East India Company under the leadership of Robert Clive fought a battle with Nawab of Bengal. and gradually East India Company occupied entire India. So the classification given by Linnaeus was in the year 1758, 1 year after Battle of Plassey. So what was the classification? So let us see. So in the year 1758, Carolus Linnaeus, a Sweden biologist, had classified all living beings into two groups. First, kingdom Plantae, and second, kingdom Animalia. Now, Plantae include plants and kingdom Animalia include animals. Now, Carolus Linnaeus divided these two categories on the basis of following features: cell wall, locomotion, mode of nutrition, response to external stimuli, and contractile system. So it was observed that cell wall was present in plants, but it was absent in animals. Second, plants cannot move, so the locomotion was completely absent in plants, whereas locomotion is a characteristic feature of animals according to Linnaeus. Third, mode of nutrition. So since plants, they have chlorophyll, they don't require to eat, they can synthesize food on their own. So all those organisms which can synthesize food on their own are classified by Linnaeus in the group plant, whereas those which require eating, they are classified in the category of animals. Next was response to external stimuli. According to Linnaeus, response to external stimuli like heat or touch was absent in plants, but it was present in animals. Contractile system is considered absent in plants. So all those organisms which do not have any kind of contractile system were classified in the plant category, whereas those which have contractile system were classified in animals. So let us try to figure out how we will classify bacteria, cyanobacteria, fungus, fern, gymnosperm and angiosperm according to the Linnaeus classification. So if we classify all these organisms, that is bacteria, cyanobacteria, fungus, fern, gymnosperm, angiosperm, then we will observe that according to Linnaeus, all of them are unable to move. So that is a common characteristic. So that means all of them are plants. Secondly, all these organisms, they have cell wall. That means we should classify all of them in the category of plants. So Carolus Linnaeus classification classified all these organisms, that is bacteria, cyanobacteria, fungus, fern, gymnosperm, angiosperms in the category of plants. But there was problem. First, this classification did not differentiate between heterotrophic and autotrophic organisms. So fungus, which is heterotrophic, that means fungus which is unable to synthesize food on its own, is placed along with the plants like fern, which are able to synthesize food on their own. Second, this system of classification did not differentiate between unicellular and multicellular organisms. That means unicellular organisms like bacteria or cyanobacteria were placed together along with the plants which are multicellular. So there were lot of confusion related to Carolus Linnaeus classification. So a scientist with the name R.H. Whittaker proposed a new system of classification which is still being followed, and this classification is the five kingdom classification. So this classification was given by R.H. Whittaker in the year 1969, and in the same year we had Indira Gandhi as the Prime Minister of the country. So under the classification of R.H. Whittaker, kingdoms were divided into five. So first Monera, second Protista, third Fungi, fourth Plantae, and fifth Animalia. Now the year 1969, when American scientist R.H. Whittaker proposed this classification, We all know that Indira Gandhi was ruling the country. But can you tell me any hit song of Bollywood in the same year, that is 1969? So yes, 1969 is also known for wonderful songs from Bollywood. And when Bollywood was dancing on the tunes of Bhavre and Kali in the movie Aradhana in the same year, 1969, at that point of time, R.H. Whittaker was busy in writing the classification of living organisms. So, R.H. Whittaker has given a wonderful classification which is considered to be the best till now. So, in this classification, organisms were divided into two groups. First, prokaryotes. So, prokaryotes are those which do not have well-developed nucleus. So, the nucleus lack the nuclear membrane. So, all these organisms which have lack of nuclear membrane are prokaryotes, and they were considered in the first kingdom, that is Kingdom Monera. Second, all those organisms which have well-developed nucleus are called as eukaryotes. So, the nucleus has nuclear membrane and it is well developed. So, these organisms are eukaryotes. Eukaryotes were further subdivided by R.H. Whittaker into two categories based on what is the kind of cell number. So, if it is the single cell eukaryote, then it is the kingdom Protista. Otherwise, if the cells are multicellular, then they were further subdivided into following category. First, was there presence of cell wall? If yes, then that means it may belong to plants. So all the organisms with cell wall, that means an outer layer of cell apart from cell membrane, then they might fall into two categories, plants or fungi. But if there is no cell wall, that means the cell of living organism possess only cell membrane and have no outer wall, then those organisms are classified in Animalia. Now with cell wall, all those organisms with cell wall were further classified into two groups based on mode of nutrition. So if they are dependent on others for food requirement, then they are heterotrophic. That means they don't have chlorophyll and they cannot synthesize food on their own. So heterotrophic with cell wall and multicellular in nature, they are considered in a group, that is kingdom fungi. However, those which are autotrophic with cell wall, multicellular eukaryotes, those were classified in the category of kingdom plantae. So overall, R.H. Whittaker had given five main kingdoms. First, Kingdom Monera. Second, Kingdom Protista. Third, Kingdom Fungi. Fourth, Kingdom Plantae. Fifth, Kingdom Animalia. Now let us understand it in more detail. So first point of classification is generally body organization. Whether the organism is cellular or multicellular. Now in entire world we find cellular or unicellular type of organisms into two categories, either Monera kingdom or Protista kingdom. So both Monera and Protista have cellular organization, whereas others have multicellular organization. Now how to differentiate between Monera and Protista? This can be done easily because Monera has absence of nuclear membrane and they are prokaryotic in nature. So monera are prokaryotic while other groups are eukaryotic. And second, nuclear membrane is absent in monera but it is present in other groups. So that differentiate monera. And that also differentiate protista, because protista are the ones which are unicellular and they have nuclear membrane. All others are multicellular and they also have nuclear membrane, but this is the main point of difference. Protista are eukaryotic with nuclear membrane and unicellular. Monera are prokaryotic, nuclear membrane is absent, and then they are cellular, unicellular. Now, how to differentiate animal kingdom? Animal kingdom could be easily differentiated because they don't have cell wall. All other groups like monera, protista, fungi, plantae, they have cell wall, but cell wall is absent in animal kingdom. So that differentiate animal kingdom from other groups. Okay, so this is done. So we are able to differentiate between animal, protista and monera. But the question is how we will differentiate fungi and plantae. So these fungi and plantae, they have all the characteristics similar. That means they are eukaryotic. Both of them have cell wall. They do have nuclear membrane. They are multicellular, but the mode of nutrition is different. So plants, they are autotrophic and fungi are heterotrophic. Okay, so now we come across with the same plants. So bacteria, cyanobacteria, fungus, fern, gymnosperm and angiosperm. So if we go according to the Linnaeus classification, then we have observed that all these organisms were placed in kingdom Plantae because all of them have cell wall and locomotion is completely absent. But we all know that this was the problem. In this classification, Linnaeus classification, there was no difference between heterotrophic and autotrophic organism. Unicellular organisms like bacteria were placed along with multicellular organisms like fern. So R.H. Whitaker has given a clear distinction between all these five categories. So apart from plant and animalia, we have three groups: monera, protista and fungi. So we are able to easily differentiate now. So bacteria, in this classification, bacteria and cyanobacteria are placed in the category of monera. Fungus is placed separately in the kingdom fungi. And ferns, angiosperm, gymnosperms, they are all plants. So this classification, that is R.H. Whitaker five kingdom classification, is one of the best classification. So earlier, as we have noticed, that all the groups were placed together. So there was no differentiation between prokaryotic bacteria and blue-green algae, that is cyanobacteria. Second, unicellular organisms were grouped together along with multicellular organism. And the classification did not differentiate between autotrophic and heterotrophic. So considering all these problems which existed in the Linnaeus classification, we have the better one. So that means R.H. Whitaker classification had created three more kingdom. Apart from plants and animals, we have here kingdom fungi. Fungi are those organisms which are eukaryotic with cell wall but heterotrophic. In this classification, we have monera. Monera means unicellular organisms which have prokaryotic nature. That means nuclear membrane is absent. And another group is kingdom protista. So in kingdom protista, we include unicellular eukaryotes. So this classification is considered to be the best, but we know that changes might take place in future, because as we grow and as we develop scientific understanding, we understand more characteristic and evolutionary relationships. So over time, attempts have been made to have a better system of classification which reflect not only the morphological feature, physiological and reproductive similarity, but also the evolutionary relationships. So these classification will be developed in future also, but right now R.H. Whitaker classification is being followed everywhere. We will be discussing kingdom monera in the next video. So please do watch my next video. Please hit the like button and subscribe to my channel Neha Green Planet. Thank you so much. Thank you all of you.